coming to Napa this Saturday is anything but fun for one local charity. Big Brothers Big Sisters says it's being used to increase participation. And get this, now 1 cent is going to their group.
It's a story that apparently is pretty common across the U.S. And if you paid an entry fee to participate, well, if there's a cancellation, don't expect a refund. Roland Barris has this On Your Side investigation.
Michelle, the company putting on the run often gets thousands of participants. And if you paid an entry fee again, it's possible there could be a cancellation, and refunds don't often happen.
The website for Run or Die promotes the event as all about fun, love, and joy. Oh, and did we mention money?
The Business Review shows an F rating based on about 170 plus complaints. Almost 70 of those have not been responded to by the company.
The parent company, Viral Events, charges $40 a person to run through a cloud of colorful cornstarch. It tries to partner with local nonprofits, but Big Brothers Big Sisters turned them down, only to find they used their name anyway.
I was pretty surprised because we did not sign any agreement with them and they hadn't promised any benefit to us. It's really troubling. It's sad.
The website for Run or Die says its events can be canceled for any reason and all registration fees are non-refundable.
So even if the forecast rain doesn't cancel the coming event at the Ford Idaho Center, something else may. And then Run or Die can just walk away with your money.
The Better Business Bureau says that's the bulk of the complaints.
An event has been canceled and refunds were not given.
On Your Side called Viral Events but got a constant recording, so there's no way to know how many people have signed up. But Big Brothers Big Sisters wants you to know they have nothing to do with Run or Die.
There are companies like this out here that are exploiting nonprofits and they're exploiting communities, and they need to be called out.
Big Brothers Big Sisters was able to get Viral Events to remove their name from the website, but only after they were informed of the problem this week, the last week before the event. Now, there's a lot of money potentially at stake here. Recent Run or Die race in Illinois had 4,000 people. That's $160,000, folks, and volunteers did most of the work. In studio, Roland Barris, Today's 6 on your side.